You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Thursday, August 15th, 2019, and today is a wonderful feast in our Catholic Church. It is also a holy day of obligation. Today is the feast day of the Assumption of Mary into heaven. Now, what exactly are we celebrating today? Well, we are celebrating the end of Mary's life on earth. As you might know, Mary lived quite a long time after Jesus died, rose, and ascended into heaven. Tradition tells us that she lived under the care of St. John the Apostle, to whom Christ gave her as a mother while he died on the cross. Now, we believe that Mary did not die at the end of her life. Instead, she was assumed by God into heaven. She was taken up into heaven, body and soul. And once she arrived in heaven, she was crowned as Queen of Heaven and Earth. So that is what we are celebrating today, the great final moment of Mary's life on earth when she was taken up into heaven, body and soul. Now, this feast day gives us a good example of something important to understand when we talk about the teaching authority of the Catholic Church, and that is the difference between tradition and dogma. Now, the word dogma means simply official teaching of the Church. The Church has dogma on several different things, on the sacraments, vocations, the nature of Christ, the nature of God. There are several points of dogma. When you are Catholic, you agree to believe them all. That is what it means to be Catholic, to believe what the Catholic Church teaches. It doesn't mean that you need to understand them all perfectly right now, but you should be working to understand them a little bit better every day. But dogma are basically the pillars. These things need to be believed and accepted if you are going to call yourself Catholic. And then there are also traditions. Traditions are things that They're oftentimes beautiful stories. They're things that maybe we don't have a ton of physical evidence for. They're sort of those stories that have been passed down through the ages. They're true, but they aren't necessary for you to completely invest in and believe and still be Catholic. So let me give you an example of these two things, dogma and tradition. So first of all, it is dogma. It is official teaching of the Church that Mary, that she was assumed into heaven at the end of her life. That is official, important teaching. It is a point of our Catholic faith. Now, on this same point, it is tradition, and Mary has revealed this to many saints throughout the years in visions and dreams, that on the feast day of the Assumption, Mary goes into purgatory and brings many, many souls with her up into heaven. That is tradition. Now, no one has seen this happen, but Mary herself has told many saints about it. And again, no one was there to hear Mary tell this to the saints. We believe them because they're good and holy people. But just because we don't have a video recording, we don't have hard evidence, it's not necessary that you absolutely 100% believe that today on the feast of the Assumption into Heaven, Mary is charging into purgatory, grabbing as many souls, holding them close to her heart and bringing them into heaven. There's no need to believe that, but why wouldn't you, right? Mary is our greatest advocate. We know that we get to heaven through Mary. We get to Jesus through Mary. And it makes perfect sense that she would be the one to storm down the gates of purgatory and bring as many souls into heaven as possible on the exact day, the day that we are celebrating, the day that she entered heaven herself. So there you have it, the difference between dogma, official teaching, and tradition, stories that have been passed down, beautiful stories that help us understand and love our faith, but aren't necessarily official teaching. One final point on this, we know that the Pope has teaching authority and that he can write something new that would be dogma that we officially need to believe. But please keep in mind that the Pope very rarely writes in this way, and he needs to be writing in an official way. Not everything that the Pope says is official teaching of the Catholic Church. It needs to be written in an official and very clear way. And so, Sprouts, my challenge for you today is to simply pray to our great mother in heaven and think about that story that she told to so many saints, that on the Feast of the Assumption today, she charges into purgatory and pulls saints' souls to heaven with her. Pray for your dearly departed and pray through the intercession of our Blessed Mother that she might go into purgatory and bring them into heaven with her today. That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow, but until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God intended you to be. A quick reminder to grown-ups, if you are part of the Catholic Sprouts Patreon community, there is a free printable to go along with this week's episode. It is an incredible coloring page of our first Pope, Peter the Apostle. I also want to remind you that there is a wonderful study guide for you to help take these topics of the Church's authority and discuss them in a way that applies to your life as an adult. You can find all these things within the Patreon community. To find out how to join us on Patreon, simply check the notes for this podcast episode.